is approximately 460 million years old. Over these long years, it has undergone many changes brought about primarily by the endogenetic and exogenetic forces. The Indian subcontinent, which was part of the ancient Gondwana land, experienced changes and evolved into its present shape and structure. Now let's see how the physical features were formed of India in our today's second chapter in geography, physical features of India. Welcome back, students. I am your geography teacher Vandana Joshi and you are watching SST 2. Students, today we are going to start our second chapter in geography, that is physical features of India. In this chapter, we are going to study about all the earth structure which were formed in India, where we will study the mountainous structure, the desert, plain, plateau, coastal regions and many more other features. So let's start quickly what will be our today's topics. Hey students, today in this chapter we will cover these topics. So first of all, we will see the introduction part, in which we will see what are the physical features. To which type of features we say that it is a physical features, and how many physical features are in our country. In the second one topic, theories. As the physical feature story of India is based upon the plate tectonic theory. So what is the plate tectonic theory and the plate movement? We will study in our second topic. Then after that, the formation of Gondwana land and some other things about the Gondwana land, we will study in our third topic. At the last, we will see introduction of physiographical division. What are the physiographical division of our country? There are total 6 major type of physical features in our country. So that a little bit introduction we will check out in our today's last topic. So let's start our today's chapter with the introduction. As we know, India is a vast country. The total geographical area or landmass of our country is around 3.28 million square kilometers. This is totally in a square form, in a kite form. So if we will go through in this kite form of our country, all the features of our country are divided into the segment part. If we will go through the introduction of our country, it is divided into various type of physical features, in which we can include the mountains, northern plains, plateaus, swampy lands, coastal areas, desertic area and many other physical features. These all physical features are resultant after many kind of forces, in that we can include some endogenetic and some exogenetic forces. Endogenetic or endogenic forces, endogenic forces or exogenic forces. Endogenic, the forces which came out from inside the earth, the forces which came from inside forces. Exogenic means the outside forces, the forces which came from outside. In that we can include some denudation process and some weathering processes through which these all physical features were formed. So what was the basic theory behind the formation of these physical features? How the country India formed? How it has been separated from the Pangaea? And what were other theory? Let's see in our second topic, that is theories. So now let's see our next topic, that is plate tectonic theory. Before going to start the plate tectonic theory, from where this theory came? We all know our earth, generally it is categorized into three layers. These layers are core, mantle and crust. And this is the first layer. This is crust. Then the next layer is mantle and this is core, also known as CR, Sima and Niphe. The Mohr discontinuity theory or Mohr-Vissé discontinuity theory is talking about the plate tectonic theory, where if you will see the layer of crust and mantle, these are having one liquid form. There is a liquid which is known as the Mohr discontinuity. It is around 5 kilometer. This is known as the Mohr discontinuity. And due to this Mohr discontinuity, because it was searched by Mohr-Vissé, so that's why it is known as Mohr discontinuity. And due to this discontinuity, because here is a liquid, so the layer of crust is gliding over this discontinuated layer. And here a theory came which is known as the plate tectonic theory. Plate tectonic theory, where the plates have to move or to glide over the discontinued or the liquid form of mantle. Where if we will say in a definition form, then moving over the weak asthenosphere, individual lithosphere plates glide before the asthenosphere. Here is one more layer that is known as the asthenosphere, and before this layer, the lithosphere, which is generally known as the crust layer of our earth or the first layer of our earth, and also divided into two parts, that is continental crust and the oceanic crust. The continental crust may be from 25 kilometer to the 35 or 40 kilometer, and the oceanic crust is a weak layer of earth's crust, which is from 8 kilometer to 16 kilometer. So these plates glide over the asthenosphere, where a discontinued layer or a molten magma is also floating, which is known as the Mohr discontinued layer, and individual lithosphere plates glide slowly over the surface of the globe. Means that is the surface of globe where these two type of crust, that is oceanic crust or the continental crust, oceanic crust and the continental crust are gliding over the Mohr discontinued layer or a liquid form of the mantle layer. That is known as the theory of plate tectonic. Let's see few more pictures and diagrams through which we will become to know what and how exactly the plate tectonic theory is working and how it was helpful to the formation of our country India and how it was helpful to form the physical features of our country. Students, if you will figure out figure number 2.1 in your book, which is about the plate boundaries, there are total three types of plate boundaries. These are showing about the convergent boundary, divergent boundary and transform boundary. What are these and how these are helpful to form a country? So first we will see the convergent boundary. The convergent boundary, where the crust is destroyed as one plate divide under another. The location where sinking of a plate occurs is called a subduction zone. There are three ways in which convergence can occur. Number one, between an ocean and continental plate. Number two, between two oceanic plates. And number three, between two continental plates. If we will look out into the second figure in this picture, that is the divergent boundary, how it has formed. Where new crust is generated as the plates pull away from each other. The sites where the plates move away from each other are called spreading sites. The best known example of divergent boundary is the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. And if we will see the transform boundary, where the crust is neither protected nor destroyed, as the plates slide horizontally past each other. Transform faults are the planes of separation generally perpendicular to the mid-oceanic ridge. As the eruptions do not take all along the entire crust at the same time, there is a differential movement of a portion of the plate away from the axis of the earth. Also, the rotation of the earth has its effect on the separated blocks of the plate portions. Let's look out some more theories. Here, one theory was known as the continental drift theory, in which if you can figure out the picture on your screen, there is a kind of jigsaw puzzle where all the continents are merged up with each other. So after moving the plates, or after based on the plate tectonic theory, the Indian plates, which were earlier not situated at the current one place, it was a little bit, a movement was there. The Indian subcontinent was located at 50 degrees south latitude, about 140 million years before the present. The formation of Deccan Taps, it was around 60 million years ago, was one of the major events during the movement of Indian plate. The formation of Himalayas started at around 40 million year ago, and the process is still continuing, as you can see in the picture. Here, a picture which is showing the movement of Indian plate over geological periods. Early India, which was around 71 million year ago, then after that it was shifted a little bit in the northern side around 55 million year ago, and the India which are seeing today, that is from the Eurasian plate it was connected, and it is around 10 million years ago was shifted in the current situation, and still it is moving. And this theory came by the drift theory, and then later from the plate tectonic theory. Let's look out one more theory, which is known as the Gondwana land theory, or we can say the formation of our country was formed after the plate drifting or the plate movement from the Gondwana land. So what was Gondwana land? Before 140 years ago, there was a supercontinent over the earth. The continent was known as Pangaea. That was known as the supercontinent as well. That continent was later divided into two parts, that is Laurasia and Gondwana. The upper one portion, the northern one portion, was known as the Laurasia, and the southern one portion was known as the Gondwana. It was a kind of jigsaw fit. If you want to fix it with each other, these all are looking like a puzzle game. Here, this is the part of Southern America. There, it is the part of Northern America. Few part of Europe and few part of Asia, in which we can include the portion of China. Then here, this one middle one part is known as the African plate. Here, it is the Indo-Australian plate, India and Australia. Later, around 140 million years or 130 million years, this plate started to move towards to the Tethys Sea. Here was a sea which was known as the Tethys Sea, and here is the line which is known as the equator line. So this plate started to move towards to the Tethys Sea, and due to that movement, and this plate of Laurasia was also started to moving to the southern side.
The southern plate started to move towards to the northern side, and the northern plate started to move towards to the southern side. And then after that, due to the drifting, due to the plate movement, these plates, they started to submerge. So many parts from the Australian plate were submerged or sinked inside to the ocean, and a new continent was formed that was known as Australia. And this Indian Ocean, Indian plate, it still started to move till before 10 million years ago. And then after that, this one portion, it came near around here, and this plate moved towards here, and the Tethys Sea totally finished. And there one folded mountain formed that is known as Himalaya. And because this plate started moved from here, and it was submerged somewhere here, so it was formed into the new country, which was known as later India. So the formation of India was fixed till here from the northern plate. It was submerged. It was around 10 million years ago. And that theory is known as the Gondwana land theory, where our country was formed, as well the Himalayan mountains, the newest folded mountains, were formed. Now let's see what were the physical features were formed after the formation of our country. Now let's see the physiographical division of our country. We know that generally the physiography of our country is categorized into three parts. These parts are the Himalayan mountains, in which the new and old Himalayan mountains are there. Number two, Ganga Brahmaputra plain is the second physiographical division. And number three is the Peninsular Plateau division. Further, these three divisions are divided again many various types, which generally categorize into six parts. And these six parts, number is the Himalayan mountain, in which that range is also divided into three parts: old mountain, new mountain, and the Shivalik range. The northern plate, which is started and it has covered most of the part of our country, and it has been formed by the rivers which were flowing from the Himalayan mountains, and it is also from the Indo-Gangetic and Ganga Brahmaputra plains. Then the Peninsular Plateau is the oldest formation of our Indian peninsula. The newest formation is the Himalayan mountain, and the oldest formation is of Peninsular Plateau, which was formed by the igneous and the metamorphic rocks. And then the Indian desert, which is situated in the western part of our country, in which we can include all the arid areas of Rajasthan, few areas of Gujarat, and also the Thar desert. The coastal plains, the coastal boundary of our country, around 6516.6 kilometer, in which we can include all the coastal plains of our country, including the swampy land. Then after that, the Iceland area. Icelands, Andaman Nicobar and Lakshadweep Iceland, we can include in the sixth one picture. Now let's see a small descriptions of these all parts in today's video, and in the next video we will study a detailed study of these all physiographical divisions. So students, in a summarized introduction of the physiographical division, first we will see the division of mountain. There are many parallel mountains ranges in the Himalayas. These ranges are separated from each other by dune valleys. There are three parallel mountain ranges. These are the Great Himalayas or the Inner Himalayas. Second is the Lesser Himalayas or the
Middle Himalayas. And the third is the Sub-Himalayas, or also known as the Shivalik or Outer Himalayas. The second physiographical feature is the Northern Plain. The Great Plains extend along with the Himalayas, and Great Plains are of the recent origin, less than 2 million year old. These plains contain a number of physical features. Along the northern margins are the pedimont plains composed of coarse pebble mixed with finer previous sediment. South of pedimont plains is a marshy tract known as Tarai. The older alluvium is known as Bangar and newer is known as the Khadar in Uttar Pradesh. There are two big depressions in Bihar known as Jala near Patna and Tal near Mokham. The next physical feature is the Peninsular Plateau, which is also known as the Indian Plateau, and is an ancient crystalline tableland. This plateau has been formed as a horst and is old and well dissected. This peninsular plateau is in triangular in shape and also made up of igneous rocks. This peninsular plateau can be further divided into three broad groups, that is the Deccan Plateau, Central Highlands and Northeastern Plateau. Then next physical feature is the Indian Desert. Indian Desert extends northwest of Aravalli Hills. The region receives low rainfall below 150 mm per year. It is believed that once this was drained by some important rivers like Saraswati and many others. Most of the rivers have almost disappeared and only a big river, the Luni, flows in the southern part of desert. Next physical feature is the coastal plains. India has a long coastline of approximately 7,000 km. It can be divided into two parts, the western coastal plain and the eastern coastal plain. The western coastal plain is a submerged coastal plain. The eastern coastal plain is border and is an example of emigrant coast. Next physical feature is the Iceland. There are two major Iceland groups in India. One is in Bay of Bengal, which consists of about 572 Iceland, namely Andaman and Nicobar Iceland, with its capital at Port Blair. And the next is of Arabian Sea Iceland, which is known as the Lakshadweep Iceland, are scattered between 8 degree north to 12 degree north latitudes and 71 degree east to 74 degree east longitudes. The entire Iceland group is built of coral deposit. There are 36 Iceland, of which 11 are inhabited. Dear students, hope you understood our today's video. Here I am giving you few very short answer type of question, which answer you can mention in the comment box. For the detailed study of the physiographical divisions of India, don't forget to watch the next video of the chapter. And for that, keep watching SST Junior.